While fighting the fire chief says they did have to deal with a series of small explosions from aerosol cans and ammunition. While no firefighters were hurt, the man staying in the apartment lost his life.
The fire was reported in Henniker around 9 o'clock Sunday night. When crews arrived, the two-story building, consisting of a garage with an apartment on top, was fully ablaze. Michelle St. Laurent lives just up the street.
I could see the flames coming up over the trees, and those are rather tall trees, and I was very nervous.
The fire chief says 11 minutes after they arrived, the floor of the apartment collapsed into the garage below. Firefighters had received some mixed signals about whether or not anyone had been trapped in the fire.
The initial report was that there was somebody in the building, and there was a little bit of confusion on the part of the residents and the people that were at the house as to whether he was in residence or not, but it turned out he was.
The area surrounding the garage is heavily wooded. St. Laurent said the wind was carrying embers toward her house, and she was worried about a possible forest fire. But firefighters managed to keep the fire contained to the building. The remote location of the garage, down a dirt road, did pose a problem.
The only water source was down on the lower part of town, so we had to call a lot of extra help out. We did go to a third alarm, so we have enough trucks to carry water up to the scene.
It took firefighters about 50 minutes to get the fire under control, and after the fire was out, they discovered the body in the building.
Because a life was lost in the fire, the investigation is now in the hands of the state fire marshal's office. So far, there is no word yet from that office on either the cause of the fire or the identity of the victim. In Henniker, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.